Wish Upon is a horror movie brought to you by the genius director that brought you Annabelle and Mortal Kombat Annihilation. We all know that those films are, of course, phenomenal pieces of cinema. And this movie stars Joey King, and it's about a young teenage girl whose dumpster-diving dad stumbles upon an old ancient Chinese wish box thing. And the box will grant you a wish, but every time it grants you a wish, somebody close to you gets murdered because they have to pay a blood price of some kind. And after walking out of this movie, I really wish this movie never existed and is wiped off the face of the earth because it's so bad. This movie, bad.
It's so bad.
Of course, this is not a surprise to me or anything. The first time I saw the trailer for this, I knew that this movie had a 99% chance of being a lazy, atrocious mess. It looked like a quick, cheap Hollywood horror that had an incredibly cliche plot that capitalized on the jump scare epidemic. But you know, sometimes there's a little part of me that wants to be proven wrong and just hope that the marketing misled me to believe that the movie is going to be hot garbage when it's actually not that bad. And guess what? It's hot fucking garbage. I honestly don't even know where to begin with this sad excuse for a horror movie. I guess I'll just begin with saying that the audience was absolutely awful, as I knew that they would be. Luckily, for one, this movie sucked, so it didn't bother me that much, and two, I sat the furthest away I possibly could so I wouldn't be drowned by people's chatter and laughter. But I know for a fact, if I were to sit maybe one or two rows up from where I was currently sitting, my experience would have been hell of a lot worse. It's shitty generic PG-13 horror movies like this that are solely marketed towards teens that ruin other good horror movies for me, because it creates a false standard and expectation for horror. This is precisely why great horror films like The Witch get ruined for me when I go into a theater, because people that go see movies like Wish Upon walk into this theater expecting a dumb trash horror like this, where the only reason why they go is to cut up with their friends as if they're in the comfortability of their own home. But I'll go ahead and move on and just start talking about the actual movie itself. I apologize that this review seems a bit scattered, but there's just so many fucked up things about this movie that it's incredibly difficult to express my thoughts in a perfectly organized manner. I'll begin with the direction. It's obviously horrible. I mean, this is the guy who has made nothing but shitty movies. Apparently, he will never really care about directing something with any kind of effort. There are just so many lines in this movie that are poorly delivered in the cringiest way possible. The movie was obviously marketed towards preteens and teenagers because it's accompanied by endless references to social media and smartphone apps. And it's also accompanied by shitty generic pop music that only a preteen would be into. The violence in this movie wasn't even entertaining to watch either because it's watered down PG-13 violence. Every single time something violent occurs, it cuts away quickly and it's usually followed by a generic spray of blood. So I couldn't even enjoy that aspect of the movie because the filmmakers were too busy about only caring about getting that sweet dough from the teenagers in its opening box office weekend. There's a guy that she crushes on in this movie that looks like he was manufactured and created by American Eagle Outfitters themselves. And they have like a first kiss scene because, you know, we were all really dying and waiting to see that. But they executed it in such a cringy way. Like right when they go in for that kiss and as soon as their lips touch, it's followed by generic teenager pop music. It was one of those scenes that maybe just put my head down in shame as I started pondering my life's decisions and just started considering about just getting up and leaving. I'll just go ahead and move to the writing because out of everything, the writing was the most foul thing about the movie. Everything down to the characters, the story, the cringy dialogue, and its predictable concept revolving around the wishbox thing, it's all completely shit. And by the way, I'm gonna be spoiling the hell out of this movie because it's really the only way that I can get you to grasp how incredibly shitty this movie is. But if you care about this film being spoiled for you, then I don't even know what to say to you because why? Why do you give a shit? This movie is completely awful. The main character of this movie is so unlikable. Her character is obnoxiously dumb and selfish for pretty much the entire film. Wish after wish, people and also her dog start showing up dead and she somehow fails to connect the dots and see the correlation. And as a quick side note about the dog, they pull the most obvious cliche with the damn dog in this movie. Of course the dog is afraid of the wish box and whimpers when he gets near the box, cause you know animals have that sixth sense and they can sense things that humans can't. Ooh, that's never been done before. And the main character of course just disregards this like the dumbass she is, and also eventually the dog gets murdered. Just like in every horror film. And it's really okay if a horror film contains these cliches, but it was just so poorly executed in the most cookie-cutter, by-the-book way, to the point where you can tell that this film did not come from the mind of somebody who wanted to pursue a certain vision. Anyway, back to the original point, which was that this main character is somehow unable to see the correlation from her wishing for things and people turning up dead. Either she's incredibly stupid, or she just doesn't give a shit, and both of those traits are incredibly unlikable for our main character to have. Even the way she worded her wishes was setting herself up for failure. For example, there's this dude named Paul that she has a crush on, and she really likes him for no rational reason besides the fact that he's cute. But anyway, she goes to her magic wish box and says, "I wish that Paul was madly in love with me." Yeah, like, that's totally not gonna bite you in the ass and make it to where Paul becomes insanely obsessed with you or anything. And guess what? That's exactly what happens. You see it coming from a mile away. Paul begins stalking her at night and secretly takes pictures of her wherever she goes. Like, why the hell did you word your wish in such a vague way that's obviously gonna set you up for disaster? And that's not the only time where she words her wish in a really dumb way. Like, after she catches her dad dumpster diving again, she goes to her wish box and instead of just saying, "I wish my dad would stop dumpster diving," she says, "I wish my dad would stop being so embarrassing." Again, why are you doing this to yourself? Didn't you learn from your other wishes that wording your wishes in such a vague way is going to have a huge consequence? Like, why is she so stupid? I know teenage girls can be dumb, but apparently the logical part of her brain is just completely absent. And on top of that, she's incredibly selfish. Like, there's a point in the movie where her Asian buddy has to figure out exactly what's happening because the words encrypted on the wish box is in ancient Chinese language or some shit like that. And eventually, after figuring it out, he comes to her telling her that every time she wishes for something, the wish box plays a song and then a blood price is paid. He also mentions that once all 7 wishes are used up, it consumes your soul. And she's just like, "I don't know what you're talking about, man. I'm going back to class. I'll see you later. Bye." And literally, in the next scene, she goes home and makes another wish. How are we as an audience supposed to care about the well-being of the main character if she is a dumb, selfish asshole? And on top of that, eventually she comes clean to her friends and asks them for help. And all they do is really tell her what she should have known and done forever ago, which is that she's an incredibly stupid, selfish person, and that she just needed to throw the damn thing away somewhere. She promises to throw it away, and guess what? She has second thoughts and decides to still keep it. Why? If the filmmaker actually gave a shit about making their main character attachable, or at least potentially attachable, they wouldn't have made her so stupid and selfish. And then piling more on top of that, eventually the Asian guy comes over and tries to help her destroy it by setting it on fire, which doesn't work, so he tries to destroy it with a jackhammer that also doesn't work. And after those 2 attempts, they're just like, "Well, we've done all we can do," and they just decide to hide it somewhere in the house. Like, why would you give up that quickly after only 2 poor attempts? And why are they trying to destroy it anyway? Couldn't they have just taken it far away somewhere and bury it where nobody could find it? That's what she was going to do earlier before she selfishly decided to keep it. So why jump to, "Oh no, we have to destroy it, that's the only option"? And by the way, they force a romance between her and the Asian guy. It's completely unnecessary and out of nowhere. It makes no cohesive sense at all. One second he is yelling at her and telling her that he wishes he never met her, and then in the next scene they're giving off doomy vibes. It's just so incredibly scattered and unstructured and all over the place that nothing really in this movie goes from point A to point B in any cohesive way. And the concept of the evil magic wish box contains no real established rules of any kind. As far as I'm concerned, there is not a single wish that you can make that's off limits. The film never even attempts to bring clarity to that. If there are really no limits to what you could wish for, couldn't you just wish that you had infinite wishes without having to pay a blood price? Oh wait a second, I forgot. I'm getting way too ahead of myself. That is way too smart of a wish for our dumbass character to make. This movie really needs her to be dumb, because if she's not, it'll be incredibly inconvenient for this movie's horrendous plot. And I also forgot to mention that the beginning of the movie shows that her mother was the original user of the wish box. It takes place at a time where our main character was a little girl, and we see her mother throw away the wish box in the trash and then proceeds to walk into her room and hang herself as our main character walks in during the act. This also raises a few plot holes that don't make any sense. If it was her mom who originally used the wish box, then shouldn't her father be aware of this of some kind? Because her father is totally oblivious to it when he finds it dumpster diving and he actually gives it to her as a gift. And on top of that, her mother throwing the box in the trash and killing herself happened like 13 years ago. So how in the hell is the wish box even still in the area? If she threw it away, that damn thing should have been well incinerated by this point in time. It's so stupid. Everything about this movie is absolutely stupid. Alright, I know I'm spending too much time talking about the plot, but here's the last bit of icing on the shit cake. Just go ahead and guess what her last wish was. She only has 1 wish left, and after being screwed over by all of her wishes, what do you think her last wish is gonna be? Just take a guess. It's, "I wish I went back in time before I found you." Like, wow, she finally realized how to beat the system. But guess what? She waited until her final wish to actually make that wish. So in the very last scene of the movie, she gets hit by a car and flies like 500 feet in the air and then dies. I almost couldn't even believe how incredibly lazy and predictable this film's ending was. Hell, what am I saying? This entire movie was predictable, not just the ending. This movie was predictable as shit from start to finish. There was not a single ounce of mystery and suspense in this movie. There's absolutely no effort in the writing at all. There's nobody in this film that you care about. The main character that we're supposed to care about is a selfish, idiotic prick that deserved being hit by a car. The violence is watered down and boring. It's marketed solely towards preteens and teenagers to have a rowdy time in the theater, and I found absolutely no enjoyment in this movie, so Wish Upon is gonna get a big, fat, ginormous, colossal F. I don't even know why I do this to myself. Hopefully this video gets its views and you guys get some enjoyment out of it, because I just put myself through hell. Well, thank you so much for checking out this video and hearing what I had to say about Wish Upon, and I highly advise you, don't go see this movie. Please, do not go see this movie. But if you have, unfortunately, already seen this movie, please leave your thoughts below in the comment section. I would love to read them. And if you really like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it amongst your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the Misfit Pawn channel to be updated on more film-related content.